So we are going to show how Venn diagrams can be used to show the validity of a deductive argument. Now there's three basic sentences or propositions that we want to be familiar with, and they each one affirms or denies that one category A is wholly or partially contained in some other category B. All right, so I'm going to go over each one with its corresponding Venn diagram because we want to represent them visually. So the first one is all A are B. Right? So when you see all A are B, what it's saying here is that everything that has property A also has property B. So if we were to draw a Venn diagram to show how these sets relate, right, we have our box representing the universe, and then we have our two circles. And since everything that has A also has B, we're going to draw our set A inside the set B, right? So set A is in set B. So that's how set A and B are related. Okay. Now, if instead we have some A are B, well, now we're saying that only some of the things that have property A also have property B. So we want to think about how do these sets relate to each other. So we still have our Venn diagram, our rectangle representing the universe, and we still have our two circles. But now we're not going to draw circle A inside of circle B, but how will we draw them? Since some A are B, we're going to have overlapping circles. So A and B will overlap. This shows that some of the things that have property A also have property B. Then the last sentence we'll look at is no A are B. All right, so we're saying that nothing that has property A also has property B. So again, we're going to represent this visually. We have our rectangle that represents the universe. All right, and how do you think we should draw the two circles to represent no A or B? Okay, so yep, we're going to draw the two circles so that they don't touch at all. Okay, so we're drawing them separately, no touching. All right, because they don't have anything in common. All right, so those are the three possibilities. And as you read arguments, know that each sentence will fall into one of these three categories. And so your job is to draw the appropriate set relationship.